everybody. The Lakers are riding a two-game winning streak, both of them coming on the road against the San Antonio Spurs, and yet I've still got Lakers fans messaging me saying that something doesn't look right, that something isn't right, particularly on the defensive end of the floor, the lack of energy, the lack of urgency. And lo and behold, Frank Vogel mentioned it. Anthony Davis had to talk about the lack of energy as well. So what is really going on here? I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Make sure you subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And don't forget to come join us over on the Flick app. You can find the link in the description down below and talk Lakers basketball directly with us. Okay, so Anthony Davis was asked about the energy after the game, and here was his explanation for what's really happening. It's usually with me on the defensive end. I played like, well, this is a family-friendly show, so let's say the X-Men Origins Wolverine version of Deadpool, defensively, but it's usually me bringing that energy on the offensive glass, on the defensive end, with blocking shots and things like that. I tried to do that and just get the team going, knowing that they follow my lead. We've got to be better with our energy, especially without fans. We have to bring our own energy every night. I think the more and more we get to play alongside each other, we'll be better. Energy and effort is something we can control. Okay, so first and foremost, are the Lakers actually worse defensively this season than they were last season? And let me throw in the disclaimer, small sample size, we're only 6 games into the season, but the answer is yes. As of right now, the Lakers are indeed worse. In fact, last season, they finished 3rd in defensive rating during the regular season. This season, they currently sit at 10th, and that is with admittedly a fairly light schedule so far. So maybe a little bit of cause for concern. However, we said going into this season that perhaps the defense would drop just a little bit, but the offense would increase given the personnel on the team this year, and we have seen that as well. The Lakers finished 11th in offensive rating in the regular season. Last season, they right now are 3rd. So in terms of net rating, they actually come out quite a bit ahead of the game, but again, it is still very, very early, and that doesn't necessarily mean that we should just accept bad defense, even if the Lakers are doing better on the offensive end, and Frank Vogel certainly will not. He is a defense-first coach. So what needs to change? Well, Anthony Davis is talking about the lack of energy and the fact that the rest of the team looks to him to take their energy cues. So he's the guy that kind of gives everybody the boost. He sets the tone. That's how he sees it. That is not the way it was last season during the regular season. During the playoffs, yes, and AD absolutely picked it up. But during the regular season, the guy who actually set the tone on the defensive end of the floor, well, there were two of them. It was Avery Bradley, and then off the bench, Alex Caruso. Those were the two guys that established the energy. Well, guess who hasn't been here this season? Alex Caruso has been out due to the NBA's health protocols, and Avery Bradley is now with the Miami Heat. Anthony Davis didn't have to ramp up the defensive energy until the playoffs. This season, with him being the origin of the energy, he's got to get it going a little bit sooner, and that's not something that he's used to. That's not what he had to do last season. So perhaps that's a little bit of what we see going on. I know a lot of people look at the fact that the Lakers don't have a true rim protector out on the floor aside from Davis, and that is potentially an issue, but I think the lack of energy has also been a big thing to the point where maybe we will see some better rim protection once the energy does indeed pick up, and AD believes it's on him to set that tone. Now, I think Davis also mentioned something really interesting when he said that there's no fans in the stands. And that's true, but that was also true during the bulk of the games in the bubble in Orlando. There weren't fans there. No, yes, they were pumping in the virtual fans or whatever. They do have some experience playing in an arena that doesn't have fans in it. So what is really different? Well, the Lakers no longer have Dwight Howard or JaVale McGee, affectionately known as Dwight McHoward. When they were on the bench, they provided a ton of energy. They were up, they were yelling the entire time. That matters when you don't have fans around. It's on the bench to fire up the team. Those guys are no longer there. Jared Dudley also is very good at doing that, but now it's just him on the bench. And so maybe it's something to keep an eye on where the Lakers bench, frankly, needs to pick things up. The guys who aren't in the game need to do a better job of getting the players on the floor fired up and locked in, because let me tell you something about defense. NBA offense is really, really, really good, ridiculously good. And if you are a step slow on defense, even half a step slow at any position, one guy on the floor being a little bit off is all it takes for NBA offenses to sniff that out and exploit it. They will punish you for any weak link on the defensive end of the floor. We saw the way the Blazers, they saw that Montrezl Harrell was off, and so they went after him time and time again when they saw he wasn't managing the pick and roll correctly. So NBA offenses are extremely good at this. They will figure you out if you are not on the same page. You need all five guys bringing maximum energy and working together as a unit in order to be successful on the defensive end of the floor. And frankly, the Lakers haven't had that so far. But is that something we really should expect? Maybe not. I mean, last season, let's face it, we were spoiled that the Lakers had the kind of defensive chemistry that they did right out of the gate. It was instant. That is not the norm. That's not what usually happens. What typically will happen when you have a lot of new faces coming in is there are bumps in the road early as the team is getting acclimated to each other, as they're getting used to being on the floor together. And that's what we're seeing right now from the Lakers. Last season was more of the outlier. This season, what we've seen defensively with the miscommunication, that's more typical of a team full of new faces. So I do still have a lot of faith that they're going to get better on the defensive end moving forward. You can still make the argument that maybe they do need a true rim protecting big, and perhaps that's something they address down the road, maybe on the buyout market or something like that. But I wouldn't look at this Lakers defense right now as a finished product. I think a month from now, they should be looking considerably better as they get used to playing together and as hopefully they figure out this energy issue. And of course, we also have to mention that the Lakers are coming off of their 17th NBA championship just a few months ago. Super quick turnaround. And so that is probably a culprit here as well as to why they don't have as much energy. Well, because there is something called a championship hangover, and they just won their title a few months ago. So it's tough to ramp things up again so quickly. But let me know what you guys think. What is really going on with the Lakers and their energy and the defensive end of the floor? Is it even something to be concerned about, considering that right now their record is 4-2 and they have an excellent net rating and still look like one of the best teams in the NBA? Is it really something that we should be worried about? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to come discuss it over on the Flick app with us. You can find the link in the description down below. If you'd like to follow Lakers Nation across social media, you can find us at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. If you guys want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Facebook and Instagram. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.